Hi there, Tyler here from Seller Accountant. I just want to take a minute to walk you through a critical resource. If you go to the resources page of my website here, scroll down a little bit. It's a little hard to find. We didn't maybe design this great, but it's working. There's some recommended readings in about eight or nine different categories. There's a book I want to highlight today because of how helpful it is as part of your quarterly planning. We're kind of just starting. It's the first week of Q3 as I'm recording this. And having a clean, clear execution plan for your business is, I think, the key differentiation. You can almost always create competitive advantage in whatever product category you're in if you just have a clear plan and execute. It sounds so simple, but it works. And so if you haven't read Gino Wickman's book, Traction, if you want a direct link to it, you can find it on the website here, but look it up, buy this book, it's worth it. If you buy the book and it doesn't help you, I'll buy it from you. And it's one of those, it's that good that I would kind of put that kind of guarantee. But one of the tools that you can actually, I think, get from his website here, that I just want to show you kind of a sample of here, is that they're calling it the Vision Traction Organizer. This is that EOS model coming out of Traction. So this is not my work. This is Gino's work. Give him full credit. But what I love about this tool is that it forces me as the business owner to articulate my entire business model in kind of 3-year plan on a single sheet of paper. And then the second page is going to walk me through the exact steps and goals that I need to hold myself accountable for the current quarter. And so just really quickly, I'm going to walk through this. You know, even if you are a solopreneur seller, which is probably maybe a third of our customers, a Seller Accountant, are just kind of doing this as it's a full-time job, but it's just their job with maybe some outsourced teammates, like my firm. Even if you're simple like that, understanding what your core values are, don't make them too complicated. You don't need more than 3 or 4 of them. And if you frankly want to steal some, these are the ones that I got from Patrick Lencioni's great book, The Ideal Team Player. They're pretty battle tested, this humble, hungry, smart. The reason you care about core values and vision, even if you're a single employee business, is they need to inform partnerships. They need to inform, obviously, employees and contractors, outsourced agencies, firms that you might hire, even supply chain arrangements. Understanding what it is that gets you out of bed is in a really critical way to make sure that you don't have bad partners. Same kind of thing is, can we articulate our battle cry in a single sentence, right? This idea of what's our core focus? What does our business want to accomplish? Don't overthink this. Literally, it might be to find the best sourcing strategy for products in this category and make money doing it. You don't need to make this a nonprofit. But clarify what our core mission is. And if you can't explain what your cause is in a single sentence, you're going to have an unusually difficult time explaining it to a future employee or maybe someone you want to bring on that's junior to help you grow the business. And then the niche, you know, my mentor always told me there are riches and niches, right? Can you find, even in a product business, as narrow a customer or as narrow a problem or as narrow a focus? So there's so many different, it could be a category, it could be a person. She could be a 45-year-old mom of 3 in an upper middle in-class income living in suburbia Atlanta, right? I mean, you could really get focused on this, because what we found in all the businesses that we've worked with is the more focused that our efforts are on solving a very finite problem, maybe it's not a demographic finite, maybe it's leveraging sourcing relationship through Hong Kong subsidiary to do this, that, and the other. What is my niche of my niche of my niche? And that's going to help me understand how I can outcompete my competitors. You're going to put a quick current year goal in here. It might be a revenue and a profit goal. And then it's going to be kind of maybe some kind of a tangible, measurable goal for the current year that is measurable, but that isn't money. And then I want you to encourage you to take this marketing strategy thing seriously. What is my brand promise if I'm trying to build a private label brand? Or what is my company promise if I'm building, even if I'm a large scale wholesale business? What should my customers expect when they interact with me? And how can I hold myself accountable? And so kind of thinking through what your key differentiators are, whether it's an IP play or a supply chain play or a margin play based on crowdfunding or marketing or advertising excellence. Understand what you're betting is your best picture of success, and kind of codify it on one sheet of paper here so that you can articulate it to investors or to banks later. You actually will probably do this 3-year picture before you do some of the left-hand side. Over here on the right-hand side here, you really get your picture of, I need to dream for a minute. Let's look 2 or 3 years into the future. What do I want my business to look like? And just talking about revenue is vanity. I want to understand, what do I actually want to be able to glean from this business as the owner you know, a 20% net profit margin in an e-commerce business would be outstanding. That's a great target. You're going to have to do some things really, really well to keep 20 points of your sales. You're going to have to do things strategically differently. And so then you're going to kind of try to think about what would some measurables, what would my business look like at the end of 3 years if I was successful in getting this revenue and profit number? I'm going to have this many products or this many sales channels or this many of this. I'm going to be able to execute this kind of launch process, whatever it might look like. Kind of try to articulate that in a measurable and then kind of in a more qualitative matter to be like, okay, I'm going to have a team that can handle X, or I'm going to have a reputation for doing Y. Just allow yourself to dream and kind of whiteboard out what does this future picture of your business need to look like. And then I would even take it a step further, whether it's outsourced or insourced, kind of lay out what your ideal staffing model might look like. You know, I'm going to be the CEO, and here's what my role is going to be. I'm going to have somebody else full time. I might have some part time people. I might have some contractors. I might have a strategy to bring on agencies or firms like Seller Accountant, right? I mean, you can do all sorts of things to map your business, but it's one of these exercises where your business needs to make sense on paper if you ever plan for it to be executable in real life. And so that's, just want to show you this. I think this is a great exercise to go through with any of your business partners. We have a version of this for Seller Account that I update pretty much every quarter. And then once you have your one-page vision plan in place, you know, now I can kind of dial into what are the key goals for this year. And even more importantly, if you remember that illustration of the rocks, if I put the bigger rocks into the jar first, I can always kind of fill the sand in around it and the small tiny pebbles. But if I always let the whirlwind of the sand kind of fill my time first, and I save the rocks, the boulders, the bigger, more important things for later, I'm never going to accomplish the goals, because there's always a certain amount of whirlwind that's just a constant churning of running these businesses. And so what this is an exercise in doing is saying, hey, do X. And who's going to be the owner here? It's Tyler Jeffco. Maybe another teammate's going to do something else. But I'm going to have 1, 2, 3 key objectives for every quarter that I'm going to commit to my team. I'm going to find some accountability partners if I'm my only team. And I'm going to commit to doing it. I'm going to commit to actually solving these problems that I'm going to believe are going to get me to my one-year picture, which I believe are going to make me able to get my three-year picture accomplished. And so I want you to kind of start thinking that way, Kurt. Start thinking in terms of vision, what I want for my life, what does my three-year business look like, kind of envision it. What do I need to do this year? What are the most important things this year that I need to tweak to make my business work? And then dial it into, all right, for this quarter, and obviously you'd fast forward the date here, but starting in the middle of July here in 2020, what are the 2 or 3, this is what's called strategic laziness, as a friend of mine says. What are the fewest number of things I could place the full weight of my energy on that if I accomplished them in the next 90 days would get me the farthest, the fastest towards my goals? And so think along those lines and come out with a very short list of key priorities. If you do that, you're going to see your business blossom and go farther faster. Take care.